new, but he's gonna come get up here and thrill you. Give it up, everyone, for Jamie Rushaway.
That'll work. That'll work. That'll work. That'll work.
Yeah, Jamie.
Wow, I gotta follow that. Like, I don't even know what I would say to follow that. I went to the Roxy, and when a guy says to you, do you think you're tough? And you say, no, I think I'm funny, he thinks you're being tough. Just as a quick follow-up to the Roxy joke. Wow. Did anybody watch the Euro that was on? I remember there was the whole soccer tournament. I'm really glad that it's over because when you look like this and your last name is Rushaway, nobody knows what you are. Like, everyone always says to me, you're something, right? And that's sort of their nice way of being like, you're not white, are you? And what I do is cool, because I'm not, half the time. And what I do is whoever wins like a major soccer tournament or anything like that, I just claim that I'm from there. Italy wins, I say I'm Italian, right? If I'm buying like food, I just claim I'm Greek. It doesn't matter. But because Spain has won like 3 in a row, if I don't start learning Spanish soon, I'm fucked, totally. So I don't know who I was cheering for. I guess I was cheering for Italy. But it was all fucked up. The other day I was in a coffee shop and I was wearing a camouflage shirt and there were some military guys in there and I felt like such a douchebag because they're like gonna go off and protect our country and do all that shit and I'm buying like 20 Timbits on my walk to the Granville Street station and I felt like such a fucking asshole and I kept thinking, you know, maybe we should make a choice like as a social sort of conscious thing that we shouldn't be dressing up like our heroes in some sort of fashion statement. Like, I can't go to the Roxy in like a fireman outfit. People are like, you fireman? I'm like, no, I'm here to get pussy. Like, that's kind of fucked up, right? So I don't do that anymore. I'm not a fireman, clearly. I work at a bar, and we had this new girl start, and it's really, when new girls start, I kind of feel bad for them. Go ahead, take your seat. When new girls start, I kind of feel bad because there's lots of guys that work there, and guys were just terrible when there's like new girls at our work. You know, we see all these terrible things. And she was attractive. And like attractive to me, I don't want to speak for anybody, but she had like the two things I look for like in a girl, which are boobs and a vagina. And that sounds crass because some girls have like no boobs and a vagina, and I'll fuck that girl. And some girls have like fake boobs and a penis, and I'll fuck that girl too. So, but this girl, she was up at the front, and we were saying all these things like, you know, oh, I wonder what she looks like, you know, in the bathtub, or with a maid's costume on and a strap on, like just like stereotypical guy things. But then one of the guys I was doing that with at work, he started dating her. And to me, that was kind of fucked up, because like now they're in a relationship, and it's a real relationship, because it says so on Facebook, and Facebook is real. But now I feel awkward, because I've been telling them for this whole time all these fucking nasty things I want to do to her. So I had him fired. And that's a long way to go, I know. I remember like being on a first date. First dates are always kind of weird because you're trying to get to know the other person, so you're talking about yourself. That's the part that I like. And then there's lots of like getting to know each other. So she was like, oh, I work in human resources. And I was like, I went to juvie. And then halfway through, she said, I don't swallow when I give head. And I was thinking, that's a fucked up thing to say on a first date, because that's something that you should learn like on the job, right? I mean, it's not something you say. It's like, you know, guys, we know this. We're sitting there. You get a blowjob, and she says, like, don't come in my mouth. I don't want to come in my mouth. And then you say, okay. And then you come in her mouth, because it's a fucking first date, and what the fuck do you care, right? And I hope that women realize how good they have at giving blowjobs. Blowjobs have, like, a 99% completion rate. I mean, it's hard to fuck up a blowjob. But you go down on a woman, like, 40-45% of the time, it doesn't work out, right? And I know this is true because never in the history of the world has a guy getting a blowjob ever given a girl the you did a good job tap on the head and then moved her out of the way and then jerked himself up. That has never fucking happened. And it's not our fault either. I mean, when you're a kid, I mean, if you had a fucking popsicle, you get the idea. It's not like my mom put down a bowl of ice cream with a cherry on top and said, no, don't just stick your fucking face in there. Like, lick upwards. I mean, what do we know? That guy, he's been there. I'm married now, so I don't, I just make jokes about blowjobs. And I don't cheat on my wife, though, because I'm lazy and cheat on your wife. There's all this shit. You gotta talk to a girl. You gotta get to know her. You know, you gotta wash your cock in her sink. Like, it's a lot of things I don't want to do. Especially when I can just go home to my loving wife and then crawl in bed next to her and then jerk off while she sleeps. Yeah, I know. Being married's awesome. We have two kids, so and our kids are great. And everyone loves their kids, so just fucking deal with that. They're smart. And it's great, though, because when their kids are young, you can see them and you can sort of decide whether or not they're going to be like, you know, the mom or the dad. When my daughter was 3 years old, I remember she said to me, Daddy, guess who loves me? And I said, who? And she said, everyone. And I was like, oh, you're just like your mother. You're going to be a fucking nightmare as a teenager, you know? But there's hope in the house because my son, he's now 3, and he was outside playing. He had like a piece of Lego or something. He shoved it in his mouth, and he looked at it, and then he like banged it against his crotch, and then he threw it away. And I was like, holy fuck, he's just like me. Because if you can't eat it or fuck it, I probably don't want it. Anyways, that's my time. Main Street, the main, Brandon.
Yes.
Thanks, buddy.
Thank you, Jamie
Rushaway, is that right?
Rushaway, yeah.
Rushaway.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Rushaway. 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 Rushaway.